Hey guys, it's me Kim from Pregnancy Blog, and I've been waiting so long to make this video, and I've been collecting all the footage from our dog Specky. It was quite a lot of work, and I know it's not fragrance related, but some people asked me to make a video about Frenchies. And yeah, overall I just really hope you guys enjoy this video, and yeah, I see you guys soon. So, me and Jesper really wanted to have a French Bulldog. We always said to each other, if we get a dog, it will be or an English Bull Terrier or a French Bulldog. And since we live in a very small apartment, we decided to go for a Frenchie. And that's also the first plus for the French Bulldog. They do really well in small apartments. Frenchies are very expensive. At least they are in Holland, and I believe that if you want a healthy French Bulldog, you should really try to invest. Of course, you can go online, find a French Bulldog for around 500 euros, but you have to be very careful with that, because these dogs tend to have a lot of breeding problems. So make sure you find a good breeder, and that's the first point I want to talk about. Finding a good breeder is very important. We found our breeder surprisingly close to our home. This woman is specialized in breeding French Bulldogs. She is very strict when it comes to picking out the owners. She also wanted to meet us a couple of times before we got Specky. We had to tell a lot about our lifestyle, how we think about how life will be like with a dog. She was very picky, and it was kind of nerve-wracking because you start questioning yourself, am I right for this dog? But unfortunately she agreed, and when we found the perfect breeder and she agreed with us, we didn't really got a date. And that's a whole separate story, but Jesper already knew the date when Specky was coming to our place. And he was about 9 weeks old when we got him, but it was a surprise for me. And it was a day when I came home and suddenly Specky was in the living room with a balloon around his neck saying I love you. It was so cute. So Specky picked up, or Jesper picked up Specky with his mother, and yeah, so it was a surprise. We already decided and saved money for the dog, but I didn't knew the date he was coming. And yeah, it was just one of the best moments of my life. But that's a separate story. So when we got Specky, he was 9 weeks old, and we already had some puppy things in our house, like toys, something to chew on. He really liked chewing from the start. We had a little cage he could sleep in, and the breeder gave us the pillow his mother slept on, so he could still get used to our home but still have the same safe feeling and smell of his mom. He was very little, he was like this big. It was so cute, and it was kind of like a Christmas present because we got him around Christmas time. So yeah, first things first, you have to find a good breeder, something with the right papers, someone that really knows well about Frenchies, that doesn't do it for the money at all, because these dogs tend to have a lot of problems. And this lady also gave us like some kind of insurance. She said, if the pup is getting any difficulties or problems within a year, I will pay everything. So that was just, we haven't used it because Specky is completely healthy, but yeah, she just paid everything. So that's step number one. So the first days when Specky was in our house, we let him sleep in our bedroom. in his little cage. And it's like, I think it's the same as having a baby or a child. He cried. It was heartbreaking. He cried. He wanted back to his mom. And I don't know, it was very difficult to ignore it because a crying puppy is just, it's heartbreaking. But you have to be very strict and ignore it. And I think after 4 or 5 days, he didn't cry anymore. And we could let him sleep in the living room on its own. Of course, you have to go outside with him every 3 to 4 hours. And yeah, he had to do his potty training. So we had a lot of old newspapers in the living room. And we started to make sure he did his little pee on the paper. And yeah, that's how we kind of trained him. And I think after 2 or 3 weeks, he didn't do his little poopy in the living room anymore. So we slowly just really stretched the hours between going outside with him, so he could slowly get used to the cold outside. And we had this very little cute sweater for him. And I think it's all about just doing your best for your pup, taking care of him, making sure he can do his thing in the house, and give him a lot of love and attention. I'm not an expert at all, but it's just how we did it. So when Specky was a little bit older, or he was like 3 to 4 weeks, we started bringing him to friends and family so he could get used to kids, but also to other human beings. And my dad really likes Specky as well. My whole family loves him, but Specky really likes just being with him. I can see it in his eyes. He just really likes it. So we just really started socializing with him, and everything went fine. I thought it would be very hard to train a little dog, but of course you don't sleep that well, because you have to wake up very early in the morning to let him pee. But everything went fine. And yeah, the first thing I also noticed is that Frenchies are very stubborn dogs. They are like me, very stubborn. So it's very difficult to, you know, learn him things, because he tends to do his own thing. But if you are very strict to your dog and very clear, everything will be okay. Specky is a very happy, curious, stubborn, funny French bulldog, and he gets along with so many people. I haven't come across someone that he doesn't like, and the other way around. I think one of the things that really made him such a social dog is that Jesper can take Specky to the office every single Tuesday and Thursday with him. So he is just around people every single time. And I don't know, he also likes riding the car. We have a special safety belt for him, and that's also something that's very important. But I will come back to that later. It's just taking Specky with us wherever we go really made him very social. And he can also be alone for a couple of hours. 6 hours is totally fine, but of course you have to go outside with him before you go away. But yeah, he is a very easy dog, to be honest. And it's just, all I can say is to people that are about to get a pup or a Frenchie, just get the Frenchie outside to other places. I think that does such an amazing job in raising your pup. Food wise, we buy our food at the vet. Specky really likes this food and he does great with this. We have tried another brand, but there were too many proteins in the food, so he was always like, you know, having a little bit of diarrhea. I'm so sorry to have to tell this, but it's the truth. But now we have a brand that works pretty good for him. I will write it down in the description bar. And he eats 2 times a day, in the morning and in the afternoon. And sometimes he gets like something to chew on in between, but not too much. A lot of French Bulldogs are overweight, and I think it's very important to keep your dog healthy and don't give him too many snacks, because, you know, dogs aren't meant to eat so many cookies during the day, especially French Bulldogs. They don't need that much exercise, and they really like to sleep, so they will get fat easily. But yeah, food wise, just go try to ask your vet or the breeder. I'm sure they have some good advice. Good dog food can be expensive, but that's also something I will talk about later in the video, because having a dog, it costs a lot of money, I think. And yeah, if you want the best for your dog, you have to invest in him or her. We also did a puppy training with Specky, and I think he was 3 or 4 months old when we did the training, I'm not sure. And it was just the basics of puppy training, and I really liked it. It was very funny to do, and we also had an exam at the end, and Specky got his certificate. It's just so much fun to get like a connection with your dog and getting to know him, and he also getting to know you as an owner. And I think what's very important and what we learned the most is that you have to be and have to make sure that you are the boss in the house, especially with French Bulldogs, since they are very stubborn and they want to own everything. You have to make sure you are the boss in the house. You have to follow your rules very strictly, but also understanding how dogs think is important. I read a book from Cesar Millan on how to understand how dogs think, and the course we did with Specky was also very informative, because during the course we also learned that a dog always wants to be in a group, and there always have to be a group leader. So as you as a boss has to make sure you stand your ground. It was a very informative thing, and that's also something you can do for yourself before getting a puppy. Make sure you learn a little bit about how dogs work. It's very important, and to me it was a very fun thing to do. Now, talking about the French Bulldog in particular, they do have a little bit of problems, and I saw some other videos on YouTube that kind of inspired me to do this one as well, to share my own experience. French Bulldogs have big bat ears that look very cute, but like, because they are standing up, a lot of dirt can come into their ears, so you have to make sure you clean their ears once a week. That's totally fine. Just use a dry cotton pad and just try to clean around the ear area. Don't go too far inside of the ear, it's not necessary, but just make sure their ears are fresh and clean. Another thing that we noticed with Specky is that his nose can get very dry. And because Frenchies have so many wrinkles, it's crazy how many wrinkles they have. A lot of dirt can come into these wrinkles, and if you don't clean them, they can get an infection, or it's just, it smells, you know. So what we do is we get cotton pads and we cook water and we let it cool down, and with the cotton pad we just clean the wrinkles. Sometimes we use a cotton bud to clean his wrinkles. Just don't use too many crazy soaps or stuff like that. Water is okay as long as you keep his wrinkles clean. And then we use Vaseline or snout soother on his nose. He really doesn't like it at all, but it really moisturizes his nose so it won't get dry and all patchy. We also clean his eyes, his eye area a little bit, because sometimes he has like these tears, and it just doesn't look very nice on him. So we try to keep it as dry as possible. Another thing we do with Specky is he's cleaning his tail, and Frenchies have like this very strange short tail that is very close to his butt, and underneath his tail there is still some space, and if you have a Frenchie you can go with your finger underneath the tail and you can feel it. And this place tends to get very moist and very red, and bacterias can come underneath the tail. So we clean his tail once or twice a week, again with just boiled, cooled water. And he doesn't like it, but he's used to it right now. And then sometimes we apply a healing cream, because sometimes it gets a little bit red. So that's something you have to look after. We do brush him once in a while. He loses a lot of hair. And since he has a fawn color, all the hairs are everywhere. It can be a little bit annoying sometimes. Also, something you have to look after are the nails. Make sure they don't get too long. You can clip them yourself, but at our vet, they have a service that they do it for free once in a while. What else is very important? Just make sure your dog looks healthy. If he is having some troubles with something, it's just very important. Another thing you have to think about when you get a Frenchie is he or Frenchies want a lot of attention. And they really like to cuddle, and if you are not a cuddly person, or you don't want a dog that wants to be with you everywhere you are in your house, Frenchies might not be the right breed. Specky follows me everywhere I go. I mean, and then when I'm on the couch in the evening, he wants to be with me and he wants to hug me, and I don't know, it's just, they are so amazing, but you have to look after it. That's also something you have to think about before getting this breed. Overall, Frenchies are an amazing breed. I don't think they are that much different than other dogs when it comes down to training them. Just check out for yourself the basics on how to train a pup. It's very important you get your info before you get a dog. Talking about the costs of having a dog, Specky was very expensive, I ain't gonna lie. He was around 1800 euros. And to some people, that might be a crazy amount of money. But if you think about it, having a healthy dog that hopefully will be with you for the next 10 years, it's not that much. And I think it's a very important thing to think about before you get a dog. Another thing I think is that the food can be a little expensive as well, and sometimes they have to go to the vet, which also can cost some money. Specky had a parasite a few weeks ago, and it's very common. A lot of dogs can get a parasite inside their bowel syndrome, but you have to go to the vet and you have to get some medicines for it. And yeah, I'm not sure what the prices are in other countries, but vets are expensive in the Netherlands. So you have to think about it before you get any type of dog. Do I have the money to take care of him? And also, if you are living with a partner, make sure you just communicate with each other and put your money away for when your dog needs something. Personally, me and Jasper save up money every month for Specky, so when he needs something, we can just use that money and don't have to feel bad about it, or you know. So it's really something to think about, and your life will change a little bit. I'm very lucky that I have friends and family that want to look after Specky when me and Jesper are gone or on vacation. But if you have to bring your dog to a dog hotel, it also costs a lot of money. So really make sure you have the time and the money before getting a dog. And yeah. Well, I hope you guys liked this video. I hope it was a little bit informative. It's very difficult for me to talk about this topic in English. But if you have other questions around French bulldogs or puppy training in general, please comment below. And thank you guys so much. And I hope you guys really enjoyed the footage of Specky I showed you. And have a nice day. Bye-bye. See you next time.